Hello, ladies and gentlemen. I just got back from pre-release. I am still suffering from pneumonia, and I didn't want to make everybody there sick, so I just bought my stuff and wished everybody luck. But I figured we could open it together, and then some of the people that were there could see what I get. I also got one of these, just because I thought that fucking Tazeret looked absolutely gorgeous. There's an Ajani one, too, but I have an Esper Commander deck that this Planeswalker would actually go really well in. We're going to open this in another video, because there's two packs of this in it. I just wanted to show it to you, because I'm excited. Are you ready? I'm ready. I'm going to try and be careful with this, because these things are neat. They put a lot of work into these pre-release packs. So yeah, this set comes out next week. We get to open some early, isn't that so cool? Oh, I love pre-release. I wish I could have played. I would have loved to see, like, just some of the weird combos people would have come together with these weird little draft kits. That's basically what this is like, they give you a bunch of stuff, and I'll show you what that stuff is, and then you make a deck out of that stuff. So it slides out. Same little cover thing. I don't understand how this opens. Oh, weird. See, it says push. It's like locked. It says push. Let's push. Let's push. Let it out. I don't understand. I don't want to break this. This is so cool. Ah, you have to push it in. Interesting. Oh, there's a dice in here. It's a 20-sided dice, you can use it for your life counter. Here, Nyx. Nice dice for you. That'll keep her out of my hair. Oh, there's all kinds of stuff in here. So that's what the inside of it looks like. It's hard to see because it's dark, but I find if I put on too much light, then everything gets reflective. As you see, really nice design little box there. I like that. That's cool. Oh, this is awesome!
Attention, citizens. There has been a breach of security at the Adventus Fair. For the safety and protection, please comply with the following consulate guidelines. Surrender all inventions to consulate representatives immediately. Submit to regular searches issued by enforcement automatons. Relinquish all outstanding and Aether quotas. Adhere to posted curfews for each zone of residence. And report any suspicious renegade activity. Do your part to keep Girapa safe. Tazeret.
That wacky guy. Okay. Rally at Gonti's Night Market tonight, baby. Oh, whoa, cool. Yeah, I forgot. They give you a random date-stamped rare to show you at pre-release. We got a green wheel liberator. It's an elf warrior. 2-1 elf warrior for one green, one other. And it has revolt. Revolt, yeah, I'll explain it here. Green wheel liberator enters the battlefield with 2+1/+1 counters on it if a permanent you controlled left the battlefield this turn. So if you lost a land, you blew up an artifact or something on your side, you get revolt. And when you play this card and you have revolt, Jesus Christ, that's a 2-mana 4-3. That's insane. Okay, I'm happy with that. Wow. And a sticker. Oh, it's a pre-sticker. What else we got? 2 packs Kaladesh, 4 packs of a set that ain't out yet. Oh, I'm excited. Okay. So, I guess let's get Kaladesh out of the way. Like, comment, subscribe if you like these videos. I love doing unboxing videos, and I love opening stuff and reading them to you. You guys seem to enjoy it. Just let me know. Very hard to tell with this algorithm stuff going on, right? Alright, select for inspection. Cathartic Reunion, Chandra Founder Ma. Also a great modern card. Fantastic. Fragmentize, baby. Failed inspection. Cowl Prowler. Ooh, a 6/6 worm for 6. That's fun. Malphis Squad. Precata Pillar Bug. Never seen that before. That's actually pretty all right. Glint Sleeve Artisan. Accomplished Automaton. Was it just lonely, or was some form of evolution inevitable? Tazeret's Ambition. All right. Uncommons. Contraband Kingpin. Scry one means look at the top card of your library. And then you can put it back on the top of the library. Or if you don't like it, you can put it on the bottom of the library. So that's really good ability. It's a decent creature. Wisp Weaver Angel. Oh, blank stuff. That's fun. Consulate Surveillance. That's a lot of energy. Wow. Now, rare is... I don't even know how the fuck to say that, so I apologize if I butcher this. Ovia Pashiri, Sage Lifecrafter. 1 green for a 1/2 legendary human artificer. 1 green, 2 generic, and tap her to create a 1/1 colorless servo artifact creature token. Okay. Pay 1 green and 4 generic, tap her. Create an XX colorless construct artifact creature token where X is the number of creatures you control. Oh, this will be so fun in Commander. Holy shit. I like it. Swamp. We got a swamp. I'm guessing so far my pre-release kit is saying I should have played green. There's a servo. It's one of those things that he makes. She makes. Here's a servo. And Nick's playing with the dice. She likes it. Alright, that's our 1 of 2 packs of Kaladesh. Is loving that dice. I tell you, like, that's like one of the best things I can get out of a Magic the Gathering product is a 20-sided dice, because I have a few kitties, and kitties apparently fucking love 20-sided dice. Built to Last. Revolutionary Rebuff. Malphist Squad. Cowl Prowler. Yeah, I probably would have played green. Weldfast Monitor. It's an artifact lizard. Pressure Point. Riparian Tiger. It's a cat. Oh, that's a fucking big cat, too. Wow. Prophetic Prism. That's a reprint. I like that card. Gear Seeker Serpent. I might have went green-blue if this is here, because this is a really good drafting card if you have a lot of artifacts. Consulate Skygate. It's a flying wall. And we're into our uncommons. Aetherborn Marauder. Ooh, that's interesting. Inventor's Apprentice. Just a 1 mana 2/3 as long as I have an artifact. Nice. Minister of Inquiries. Oh, that's a limited... Yeah, I probably would have went green-blue if I got a couple of these. I think I only got one, though. But, like, yeah... As long as you can generate energy, you're milling them every turn with this. A rare. A Gyarapir Orrery. That's 4 mana for an artifact. Each player may play an additional land on each of his or her turns. At the beginning of each player's upkeep, if that player has no cards in hand, that player draws 3 cards. Fantastic. This is going in like every commander deck I've ever built ever. It's group hug. It's friendly. And... everybody gets benefit from it, so they're less likely to blow it up. And you can build around it. Island. We got an Island. And there's another servo. Alright, now into the new stuff. Because that's what you're here for, right? This stuff. Well, we got 2 Ajani packs. Let's start with an Ajani pack. What cards are you excited out of Aether Revolt? Are you aware of any of the cards in Aether Revolt? Let me know. My local Magic store seems to be taking a shit kick, and I'm hoping that ban thing fixes it. Take into custody. Ooh, that's fun. Slows him down for a couple turns. Gyarapir Osprey.
Nixie! Take that dice and go over there. Get that dice.
Motherfucking baby, Nix. much smell the cards, do you? Yeah, it's a bird, but you can't eat it. Wrangle. Ooh, that'd be a fun card to draft with. Defiant Salvager. That'll trigger Revolt. Prey Upon. That's a reprint. And that's a good reprint for green, because that's, like, essentially removal. You target one of your big things, and you target one of their little things, and then it dies, and you don't. Ooh, a vehicle. Iron Tread Crusher. It says we've been through a lot together. Love it. Vehicles are so fun. Hey, a reprint. Negate. Counter target, not creature spell. Useful counter spell there. Consulate Turret. I love this card a lot. Because it taps and gives you an energy, so it's a repeatable source of energy. But then you can also tap it and pay 3 energy and do 2 damage to target player. It's inevitability. I like it. Aetherstream Leopard. Nice. Welder Automaton. We're into our uncommons now. Oh, it's one of the pirates. Skyship Plunderer. Holy fuck, that puts counters on thing. Okay, that's useful. Deft Dismissal. Removal. Illusionist's Stratagem. Oh, Jesus. Let's blink on steroids and draws you a card. Nice. Interesting. Rare. That's Yenny's Expertise. 2 black, 2 generic for a 4 converted mana cost spell to give all creatures -3/-3 until end of turn, so that'll kill a lot of stuff. You may cast a card with converted mana cost 3 or less from your hand without paying its mana cost. What? This is insane. That is insanely good. Alright, so you just wipe out all the little things, and then you can pay, like, a 3 mana removal to blow up the big thing, or you can just drop down one of your own things. Like, wow, that's good. Okay. Got a mountain. And a servo token. A lot of servo tokens you'll notice in these sets. That's okay, because a lot of stuff generates servo tokens. Alright. I think it's Tezzeret. Yep. Or Tezzeret. I'm not really sure how to say it. But we'll see. Dispersal Technician. Dawn Feather Eagle. Wow, that's actually pretty okay. Emerald Gear Smasher. Silk Weaver Elite. Nice. Daring Demolition. Destroy target creature or vehicle. Neat. Night Market Guard. Destructive Tampering. Oh, a choosing spell. Cool. Destroy an artifact or creatures out flying can't block. That's a fun card. I like that. I like anything that gives me choice. Foundry Assembler. New mechanic. Improvise. Your artifacts can help cast this spell. Each artifact you tap after you're done activating mana abilities pays for 1. In other words, say I got some servos out. So this costs 5, but it has improvise, so I could tap the 3 servos, and then I'd only have to pay 2. Because these pay for 1, because they're all artifacts. So you can get big things out cheap. Another negate. Prize Fighter Construct. Ew. Ooh, I would hate to draft this. Okay. Uncommon. Ironclad Revolutionary. In herbalists, they're the worst kind of herbalists. Wow, if revolt's triggered, if something left the battlefield on your side this turn, this pays for itself. It gives you 2 green and it costs 2 mana. That's cool. Pacification Array, it's like Icy Manipulator. It costs a little more to activate, but it's way cheaper to play. I like it. Strom's Expertise. 2 white. 2 generic mana for a sorcery. Create 3/1/1 colorless servo artifact creature tokens. So these guys. Create 3 of these dudes. Then what else do you do? You may cast a card with converted mana cost 3 or less from your hand without... What? Oh, there's a whole cycle of these, isn't there? Oh my god, magic's getting stupid sometimes. Okay. We got Swamp. And a Thopter token. I'm okay with a Thopter token. Wow, those free spells are insane. Because both of them have been very good so far. One wipes out creatures and one makes you three creatures. And then you play something for three mana or less. Alright. Into Land Drake. For some reason he can't block artifacts. Conviction. I think that's reprint. Get a per Osprey. Ooh, Druid of the Cowl. I miss the days when mana dorks only cost one green to play, but, you know, that's not bad. They can block, too. Alley Strangler. The Rogues. You never know what day might be your last. I like this card a lot. Unbridled Growth is an enchantment. You enchant a land. Now the land that you enchant can tap for any mana, as opposed to the mana that it can normally generate. And then when you need a card later, you can sacrifice this enchantment to draw a card. Verdant Automaton just gets bigger forever. Ice over. Makes things not on tap. That's fun. Watchful Automaton. Oh, activate Scry 1. Wow, that's cool. Augmenting Automaton. This one just makes himself bigger. That's actually pretty good, too. Uncommons. Gremlin Infestation. Oh, that's cool. Maverick Thopterist. Oh, God, this is the thing that you can tap artifacts to help to play. It's a 2-2 for 5. Whenever it's a battlefield, create 2-1-1 colorless Thopter artifact creature tokens. When this comes into play, you get 2 of these. That's a lot of value for one card. Wow. Reckless Racer! Oh, okay, you use them to crew your vehicles. Because any creature can crew a vehicle, but when you tap this guy, you can discard a card and draw a card, so he... Okay. And here's a rare. Aether Sphere Harvester, 3 mana for a 3-5 flying vehicle. When it enters the battlefield, you get 2 energy counters. Pay an energy counter, it gains lifelink until end of turn and crew 1. What? They just banned the Smuggler's Copter. This isn't as good, but fuck, it has lifelink. Generates energy. Cost nothing to... I like it. I like this a lot. It's probably actually more fair. Island. And a servo token. Oh, that's a neat-looking servo token. And our last pack of Aether Revolt today. Oh, man. What would you draft out of these packs? Because, like, white and green's looking pretty strong. Maybe Abzan. Go white, green, black. Use all the rares. Because, like, I mean, I haven't really been going over the commons and uncommons. Some of them are really crazy strong, too. Let's see. Take into custody. Bastion Enforcer. Oh, they reprinted Shock. Cool. Okay, so Shock's in standard again. That's nice. I like how they have the... I think that's a young Pyromancer there, too. Cool. Lifecraft Cavalry. Cavalry. Night Market Aeronaut. Consulate Turret. Ooh, I like having more than one of these. Okay. Aetherstream Leopard. He's a 2-3 for 3. Welder Automaton. Foundry Assembler. Uncommons. Outland Boar. Outland Boar. Living in an outbound. It's alright. Sly Requisitioner. Oh, Jesus Christ. Whenever a non-token artifact you control is put into the graveyard from the battlefield, create a 1-1 server. Jesus, that's just endless artifacts. Ridge Scale Tusk. Wow, green is strong in this set. Holy shit. 5-5 for 5. Whenever there's a battlefield, +1/+1 counter on each other creature you can... Fuck. Rare. SRAM. Senior Edificer. 1 white, 1 generic for a 2-2 Legendary Dwarf Advisor. Whenever you cast an aura, equipment, or vehicle spell, draw a card. Wow. That's really cool. I like that. And a foil Yanni's Expertise. Holy slap nuts. To quote Jeff Jarrett from 1999. Oh, wow, that's so cool. I'm so happy with it. Wow. Forest and... Oh, cool. An energy counter thing. I didn't even know if they made those or not. Okay, so you just put your counters on that when you get energy counters, and it tells you how many energy you have. So, green-black seems like what I draft here. What would you draft? Let me know. Remember, the Aether Tears Harvester's here, too. I just kind of lost my shit over the foil Yenny's expertise. Wow. Alright, guys, like, comment, subscribe if you enjoy this Magic the Gathering content as much as I do, because I love doing it for you. You guys seem to like watching it. Just let me know if I'm crazy for thinking that. Leave me some likes. Tell me what you draft and all that fun stuff. And until next time, this is Daddy saying bye-bye. And holy shit, that foil. Good look at it. Broken as shit foil. Sweet.